Alex Rober here with head coach of the women's basketball team, Jerry Porter. First of all, thank you for sitting down and talking to us ahead of the game tonight.
No problem.
What has the team stressed in practice since the Conference Carolina's South Atlantic Conference Challenge?
You know, our stress, Alex, over the last really 6 weeks or so as we prepare for the start of the season has been defense. Like, we decided coming out of last season that we were a team that did a pretty good job putting the ball in the basket, but we had to do a better job defending teams. Not sure we got that done last weekend, but that was kind of the focus and the intention. And then we came back off of this weekend and did the same thing this week. Tweaked some things, made a few adjustments. Obviously, this week we talked a little bit about being better on the offensive side of the ball, being a little bit more patient offensively, running offenses through and giving defenses a little bit more of a challenge than just maybe making one or two quick passes and a shot. So there were some things that we were able to learn from the weekend that we were able to come back in. But still, the main focus for us has just been defending, being better on the ball, defending as a unit, being better as a team defensively, and then rebounding. We've got to be a better rebounding team if we're going to win games this year.
Zoned in on rebounding and defense there. So would you say that has been your strength that you can rely on through these first two games?
Honestly, I think we could be better. I don't think we've been terrible, but I think we could definitely be better in both areas. Rebounding in particular. Rebounding is an area I thought that against a bigger Wingate team, we had to be more intentional about putting bodies on people and actually blocking out. Like, we talk about the difference in blocking out and rebounding, and making sure that our kids understand that you know, you got to put a body on somebody first, and then you can go, you know, secure the rebound. So those are the things we've been stressing this week for the 2 days that we've had to prep for Newberry.
Absolutely. What are you looking for specifically from the girls in the first 5 to 10 minutes tonight?
I think just energy. I think sometimes when you come off of a tough weekend like we just played, sometimes your confidence tends to be affected a little bit. I want to see our upperclassmen, our kids who have been through some battles before and dealt with a little bit of adversity. I really kind of want to see them step to the forefront and be leaders and make sure that we step on the floor with the same level of confidence and energy that we stepped on the floor on Friday and Saturday with, and not allow, you know, missing the mark a little bit over those last two games to get into our heads and affect us going into tonight's game. So really just the enthusiasm that we had over the weekend to jump into those games, jumping into our season, bring that back tonight and make sure that we get off to the right start in the first 5 minutes tonight.
Absolutely. How do you feel overall that the girls match up against Newberry?
Newberry is big. They've got more size than we do. I think we've kind of settled into the fact that a lot of teams are probably going to be a little bit bigger than we are. They've got shooters all over the floor. I think that our length and our athleticism, particularly out on the perimeter, one of the things that we've talked about over the last couple of days, is doing a little bit better job applying pressure on the ball. I think people will see us be a little bit more aggressive defensively with this team. They're not super athletic, but they're very skilled. I think the more opportunity you give them to run offense and to get their feet set and get the looks they want, the more dangerous they're going to be. So we've talked a lot about just trying to disrupt with our defense, more pressure on the ball, getting up in passing lanes, just being in general more aggressive and trying to disrupt them. So I think the matchups are interesting. I think that we're two very different styles in terms of the way that both teams play. And I think the team that does a better job kind of exerting their will, you know, playing to their strengths is going to be the team that comes out on top tonight.
No question about it. Well, good luck tonight, you and the girls against Newberry College.
Thank you so much, Alex. Good talking to you.
Thanks.
The women's basketball coach returning for her seventh season here at Francis Marion University. She faces a unique foe in that of Newberry College. Newberry College has some familiarity with FMU, not with recent play, but their head coach is at Francis Marion University, 2004 graduate. We are thrilled you're here to join me for this matchup. This is Paul McDonald. We are super thrilled to bring you this matchup, the home opener for Francis Marion University here at the University Center. The matchup, a non-conference matchup between FMU and Newberry College. Both squads matching up with returning starters from last season. So both squads very seasoned in their expectations for this year. Frances Marion coming off of a 13-11 Conference Carolinas record. Newberry nursing a not as great record in the SAC last year. Both squads come in with identical 0-2 records on the season. So both squads attempting to get their first victory of this young 2022-2023 season. The visiting squad is the Newberry Wolves, as we mentioned a moment ago. The head coach, the 2004 graduate of FMU, is Joanna Tincher, assisted by Samantha Price and Coco Lung. Let's give you that lineup for Newberry College. For Newberry College, starters, number one, Holly Davies. She's a guard senior from Camberley, Surrey, England, a Hillsborough Community College transfer. Number 20, Ella Pearson. She's a guard, 5'10" sophomore from Sudbury, Suffolk, England. She comes from the Thomas Gainsborough School. Number 23, Julia Bongiorno. She's a guard, 5'10" senior from Rome, Italy, transferring in from Florida International University. Number 31, Peyton Cronin. Another guard, 5'7" junior from Louisville, Kentucky. She comes from Assumption High School in Kentucky. And rounding up the starting five for Newberry, number 35, Erica Wisely. She is the center patrolling the paint for Newberry College. The Wolves, 6'2" senior from right down the street in Mount Pleasant, South Carolina. She hails from Wando High School. Now it's time to bring to you the starters for Frances Marion University. And these are some names you're going to recall from last year. All of these returning starters from last season. So, again, a very seasoned squad is Jerry Porter's team. Jerry Porter, the head coach, now in her seventh season at FMU. Jeanette Walker assists for the Patriots. Also assisting is newcomer Ryan McGee. So let's start with the starting squad for Frances Marion. A sharpshooting guard, number 4, Scarlett Gilmore. She is a 5'7" senior from Rock Hill, South Carolina. She hails from South Point High School. Next, the point guard is number 11, Anaya Oliver. She is a 5'5" junior hailing from Goose Creek, South Carolina. Taking it down underneath the rim, number 22, Jasmine Stanley. She'll see time as forward and center. She is a 6'1" senior coming from North Myrtle Beach, South Carolina. She is a Goose Creek High School native. She's a transfer from Alabama A&M University. Number 25, Kiana Lee, is the starting guard, two guard for Frances Marion. Kiana is 5'7", sophomore from North Augusta, South Carolina. She is from North Augusta High School. And last but not least, the fantastic center for Frances Marion, Lauren Taylor. She is number 32, and she is a woman to watch underneath in the paint. As I mentioned, a center, 5'11", plays much taller than her 5'11 stature. The junior is from Blythewood, South Carolina. She hails from Spring Valley High School. Give credit to Lauren Taylor. Lauren Taylor picked up Player of the Week honors for this past week for the Conference Carolinas. So as we wrap up Frances Marion's lineup, let's talk a little bit about FMU's season last year. FMU last year, 13-11 in conference play, overall 18-13. And uniquely, of all of their starters, they really only surrender one to no longer be on the squad. That's Zaria Woods. So the rest of the squad and all of their points are retained for that of Frances Marion. Really excited to see what the starters for FMU, all returners from last year's squad, can do for the Patriots. A similar story for that of the Wolves. The Wolves return all of their players from last year's start. So a tale of two teams, extremely experienced and ready to go. We're prepared for the tip. It'll be Jasmine Stanley tipping off with Erica Wisely in the middle. Credit the tip to the Patriots, and we're off and running. Anaya Oliver over at the three-point line. Kick it back to Kiana Lee. Kiana Lee guarded nicely by number 20, Ella Pearson. Patriots willing to take their time on this first possession. Down to 8-7-6 on the shot clock. Shot from Lauren Taylor is missed. How about a rebound for Frances Marion? First rebound of the day for Scarlett Gilmore. So moving the ball around the elbow is number 11, Anaya Oliver. That ball is missed out of bounds, so possession to Newberry. Frances Marion in a full man press. They're going to back off. Scarlett Gilmore guarding the guard in Holly Davies. Davies to the sideline, handling the ball around the wing. Currently in a man defense, handling the ball nicely. Up and under is Erica Wisely for the first points of the game. Oh, fast break to Kiana Lee. Kiana Lee is blocked. Erica Wisely on one end with the score, comes all the way down on the other end to get the block on the attempted fast break for Frances Marion. So inbound, no problem. Ball to Scarlett Gilmore. Gilmore drives the lane, kick it out. How about two for number 11, Anaya Oliver, getting on the board. 8:43 to go here in this first quarter. FMU with an early 3-2 lead. Ball back in the hands of Newberry. Continuing in a man coverage is the Patriots defense. Anaya Oliver on defense, causing Julia Bongiorno to travel. No complaints from Coach Joanna Tincher. She acknowledges that the travel was had, so possession back to the Patriots. Working underneath is Jasmine Stanley. Kick it out for a three-point attempt is Gilmore. Gilmore with the miss. Here comes Newberry on the run. Good ball around the perimeter for Newberry. Skip pass to Holly Davies. Flip it underneath to Erica Wisely. Wisely with a foul. She's going to go and one. Scratch that. Instead, it's going to be an on-the-floor call. Possession back to the Patriots. So Patriots avoid trouble on that particular play. Pass to Kiana Lee. Kiana Lee decides not to press the subject. Lee back to Oliver. Oliver defended by Holly Davies. Davies is going to take on the defense against the point guard. Jasmine Stanley goes high on the glass. That ball gets no rim. Rebound and numbers for Newberry. Kick back for the possible tray. However, ball mishandled. Newberry with a reset. Three is missed by Peyton Cronin. Lots of scramble on the side of the Patriots. We're going to get a foul. Kiana Lee, couple of opportunities for the Patriots to go ahead and collect that ball on the rebound. However, ball trickled off the fingertips. Good effort by Newberry to collect the ball. We'll have our first free throws on the side of Newberry. Going to the line is Ella Pearson. Pearson last year a 378 free throw shooter. However, today 1-for-1 with that knockdown. Scratch that free throw number, make sure we got it right. She's a 667 clip last year, but she only took 15 strokes from the charity stripe, so it's definitely not a land she is used to. Good pressure by Newberry. Flip it underneath. Efforting is number one, Holly Davies. She's going to draw the foul from Scarlett Gilmore. It was numbers on the side of Newberry based on a turnover from Frances Marion. The result, transition play for Newberry. And while they didn't get the bucket, they do draw the foul. Davies at the line. She is true. And we're starting to see Newberry's MO. Newberry with some rebounding with their slightly longer length than the slightly more diminutive Frances Marion University squad. FMU is going to have to figure out how to handle the glass to ensure that second and third chances for Newberry are limited. Good pressure by Newberry. Frances Marion breaks the press. Anaya Oliver is going to slow it down over to Kiana Lee. Key Lee handles it. Over to Jasmine Stanley. Kick out to Oliver. Oliver's going to take it to the hole. And it's going to be an offensive foul. Good positioning by Julia Bongiorno. So that's going to be a charge against the Patriots and I, Oliver. Newberry with a 6-3 lead here, 6:47 to go here in the first quarter. Julia Bongiorno drives the lane. It's going to be another travel. Bongiorno looks a little bit puzzled by that call. However, possession back to the Patriots. Newberry continues to put significant pressure on in the full court. Gilmore casually to Lauren Stanley. Stanley casually to Oliver. A lot of no-look passes trying to break that press. Patriots do break it, though, successfully. Slip it underneath. How about a bucket for Scarlett Gilmore? I like that backdoor pass. Excellent work to get the ball underneath to a driving Gilmore down the lane. Gilmore knocks it down. Missed shot by Newberry. Patriots rebound. Nia Oliver dribbles up the lane, up the sideline, I should say. Getting into their half-court offense are the Patriots. Lauren Taylor decides to throw up the three. And she had her toe on the three-point line, so that's going to be two free throw opportunities. Erica Wisely with the hack on Lauren Taylor. So Taylor's going to get two strokes from the line. Entering the game for Newberry, April Rummery Lamb, number 12, comes in. 6'4", sophomore from Darwin, Australia, and the Essington School, making her first entry into the game. So length and more length abound for Newberry. Meanwhile, Lauren Stanley knocks down both of her charity strokes. It'll be the long Newberry coming in. Bongiorno is going to handle the ball duties, bringing it up the court now to Davies. Davies is going to take the 20-footer. No avail from Davies. Another rebound. Rebound from Rummery Lamb. Good ball movement from Newberry. Quick jump stop from Bongiorno. She can't seem to knock it down. Anaya Oliver with the run-up. Oliver slip it to Jasmine Stanley. Stanley with the muscle. Count it and one. Jasmine Stanley with work underneath. Newberry a little bit longer, but a little bit slow to get back to defend the quick Jasmine Stanley. Jasmine Stanley was able to take it right to the glass. That was her second attempt of the same ilk, coming from the right side, getting it up on the glass. First one didn't make. This one did. She gets the and one on the foul against Ella Pearson, number 20 for Newberry. So it'll be one shot for Jasmine Stanley. Two Patriots back on defense. So awaiting the rebound is Newberry. Count the and one for Jasmine Stanley. Excellent work by Stanley to get the job done. Last year, sometimes those and ones weren't converted as frequently as I think Coach Jerry Porter would like. When you get the opportunity to go to the stripe to turn it into a three-point play, you got to knock down that third. Jasmine Stanley does just that. Patriots on top, 10-6. Possession to Newberry. Handling the ball is Davies. Davies back to Faith Putz into the game for the first time. Putz from Des Moines, Iowa. She transfers from Kansas City Community College. There'll be a foul on the floor. So possession to Newberry. Newberry will bring it in. Bringing in the ball is Diane Burke. Long pass from Holly Davies. Is sent just long. We'll get our first timeout of the matchup. FMU with the lead, 5 minutes to go here in the first quarter. FMU on top, 10-6.
pizza, better with Pepsi.
Welcome back to the Smith University Center, where the Patriots have taken a 10-6 lead at the first media timeout. 10-6, your score, 5 minutes to go here in the first quarter. It's been a flourish for the Patriots. Jasmine Stanley knocked down the three-point play just moments ago to increase that FMU lead. Jada Richards now out on the floor for the Patriots. Jada Richards, Douglasville, Georgia sophomore, out on the floor. Another returner for the Patriots, so experience continues. Also on the floor, Trinity Adams. That's our first newcomer on the floor for the Patriots. Rock Hill, South Carolina product. Out on the floor, playing in the three. And that shot is on time. Kiana Lee kind of slapping her hips, saying, hey, we didn't get the shot that we wanted. Got to work that ball around. I tend to agree with Kiana on that one. Newberry with quality defense to work that shot clock down to nearly zero before the Kiana Lee stroke. Excellent defense preventing the easy three. Jada Richards on defense handling that ball. Deflecting the ball. Entering the game for Newberry, more length. Mercer Roberts, the forward, 6 foot tall from Myrtle Beach, South Carolina, getting in on the action for Newberry. And we're going to get contact on the floor. Deanna Burke is going to go to the rim. No, they're going to say that it is an offensive foul against Deanna Burke. So quality work by the defense of the Patriots to get set. And that'll be a foul against Newberry. Buongiorno now back into the game for the Patriots. And it is going to be a foul in the full court. Deanna Burke with the foul. Well, so that press is really the greatest effort for Newberry. Newberry has pressed most of the game. They've been in a man press, also a zone press on that last set. So Newberry doing everything that they can to get the defense going to slow the Patriots' run. Lauren Taylor with the three is missed. Rebound to Newberry. There's Buongiorno bringing up the ball. Oh, flip it up to Rummery Lamb. Lamb underneath has no problem knocking it down. Patriots back up the floor very, very quickly. Kiana Lee, flip it underneath to Trinity Adams. In and out is the Trinity Adams shot. Newberry now on the run. So the Patriots content to allow Newberry to get into their half court. Meanwhile, Newberry on the flip side is pressing the Patriots on most of their possessions for the full court. Handling the ball, Deanna Burke. She's going to flip it over to Rummery Lamb. Kick it out to the corner for a tray from Faith Putz. Faith Putz with a miss. Rebound. Lauren Taylor. Anaya Oliver now is going to handle the ball. Bring it up to Taylor. Flip it around to Jada Richards. Now to Adams. Adams is going to try the tray. Rim out is the swing from Adams. Underneath, easy bucket for Newberry. Mercer Roberts with her first points of the action. Height seems to be the answer for Newberry. Speed is what Frances Marion is really trying for. Speaking of speed, bit of a mishandle on the pass. Kiana Lee flicking it over to number one, Trinity Adams. Adams couldn't handle it. That ball trickles out of bounds. Newberry to take possession. So out of that last timeout, 4 quick points for Newberry. We are deadlocked at 10, 2:25 to go here in the first quarter here at the University Center. Newberry with good ball movement, moving it around the perimeter. Reaching in to make the stop was number 22, Jasmine Stanley, but it's going to be a 3-second call underneath for Newberry. Well, I can see that as a concern for Newberry. Newberry with their length, they want to hang out in the paint. But, of course, they have to observe those rules of only having 3 seconds, less than 3 seconds in the paint. They are guilty of that one moments ago. So deadlocked at 10. 2 minutes to go here in the first quarter. Anaya Oliver with a little shake and bake. Kick it to Jasmine Stanley. Stanley gives it a look. Rebound to Newberry. Only one player underneath for Frances Marion. 3 for Newberry. It's no surprise Newberry with the rebound on that one. Oliver on the run. She's going to kick it back. mishandling the ball on the underneath, but how about that rebound? I love that follow from Lauren Taylor. Lauren Taylor follows the action just in case there was a miscue. Sure enough, there was. She's there to collect the rebound, then take the lay-in. Bongiorno now at the point, being guarded nicely by Trinity Adams. Bongiorno had to give it up. 3-point from Putz is off the mark. Patriots with a 12-10 lead. Jasmine Stanley up top, flip it underneath then to Trinity Adams. Adams taking a page from the Jasmine Stanley playbook. Stanley taking the ball down the baseline for a couple of attempts on the glass. This time Trinity Adams does just the same on a pass from Jasmine Adams, from Jasmine Stanley, scratch that. So it's Adams at the line. Adams will have two chances from the free throw stripe. So Trinity Adams, the newcomer from Rock Hill, South Carolina, seeing her first action of the day. Adams averages about, 21 minutes a game here this season. So she is a key cog in what is otherwise a very experienced Patriots squad returning this season out on the hardwood. Bongiorno is going to shake and bake to work her way around Trinity Adams. Adams defending nicely. Stepping in, putting pressure is Rummery Lamb. Lamb can't make it. Anaya Oliver works it out with the rebound. Oliver's just going to take it to the hole. Bit of an errant shot there. She got caught a little out of balance. Stuck underneath the rim just a little bit. Therefore, she got a little bit of rim rejection. She got some glass rejection. So entering the game for the first time, another newcomer, it's Alexis Sexton coming onto the floor. She gets about 8 minutes per game so far early on this season. So Sexton's going to handle the ball, spelling Anaya Oliver at the point. Sexton's going to have to get back on the break for Newberry. Count the three. Peyton Cronin has tried a couple of times from that baseline corner. And two quick problem scenarios in a row. Quick baskets, 5 points in a row for Newberry as we end the first quarter. About a minute and a half for Sexton, and those were the minutes where 5 points were quickly put out on for Newberry. Newberry, after one quarter, leads 15-13.
Year after year, with unwavering dedication, McLeod Health has stood shoulder to shoulder with families, friends, and neighbors, bringing healthcare expertise and compassion to all the communities we serve. As the region's most trusted healthcare resource, our physicians are here for you. Our nurses are here for you. The entire McLeod family is here for you. McLeod Health, here for life.
If you had to pause your favorite show because your spouse fell asleep, you've compromised enough. Pepsi Zero Sugar.
We wrapped up one quarter of play. Newberry with the lead, 15-13. We want to talk a little bit more about what either squad is wanting to do here in this new season. For Newberry, it's really got to be scoring, averaging only less than 60 points per game last year. They really want to up those numbers. For Frances Marion, scoring's not really the problem, 72 points per game. So if averages from last year were the case, you'd see an FMU victory. But instead, Newberry putting some quality pressure and some quality rebounding out on the floor, causing problems for the Patriots. Up and under was Erica Wisely, defended nicely by Jasmine Stanley. Wisely's miss is rebounded. Possession back to Newberry. 10 seconds on the shot clock for Newberry. Newberry's going to continue to work it around the perimeter. 4 seconds to go. Count the tray from Bongiorno. So Bongiorno getting on the in on the tray action. Bongiorno leads the way in scoring with 5 points for Newberry. Jasmine Stanley is going to kick it back to the point guard and Alexis Sexton. So Anaya Oliver just getting a break. She's got some work to do later on today. So Sexton is most certainly in to spell Anaya Oliver, give those legs a fresh rest before coming back out onto the floor. Bongiorno continues to handle the ball. Great pick by Erica Wisely, creates some space. Distraction up high results in a score down low. And with that, Coach Jerry Porter doesn't like that look. Newberry opening up a 7-point lead. Newberry now 20-13, 8:50 to go here in the second quarter.
Francis Marion University provided me opportunity in basketball and education. After graduation, I played professionally and started my own business. Today, I'm an assistant admissions director helping the next generation of Patriots. Because an education at Francis Marion opens doors to a world of opportunities.
Dude. Fire. Grillmaster, huh?
Burgers, better with Pepsi.
So Newberry opens up a 20-13 lead here early in the second quarter. It's a timeout from Coach Jerry Porter stopping the action. Now out on the floor, Anaya, Malaya Owens getting her first opportunity at point guard for the day. There'll be a 3-point stroke way off the mark from Jada Richards. Kiana Lee with the putback. Excellent work by Lee. Collect that rebound, get the ball back. Wide open tray from Bongiorno. Rebounded. Scarlett Gilmore gets the ball. And at first, Gilmore thought that it was going to be possession to Newberry, but instead it is possession Patriots. Therefore, Jasmine Stanley will return to provide the inbound. Newberry continuing to press here in very much a man press, pressing the inbound, pressing the ball, and eventually Newberry is going to recede. Put a little bit of pressure up at the half court line. I like that pressure from Newberry, giving FMU a very hard defensive look before they get into their half court set. Richards is going to give it another shot. And when you're a shooter, what's your job? Your job is to shoot. And if you miss a couple, you got to keep at it. Richards, absolutely a sharp shooter for the Patriots. She'll look to get going here shortly. Driving to the floor is Holly Davies. That's going to be a travel. So continued defensive pressure from the Patriots on Newberry's drive has really relegated Newberry, for the most part, to outside shots. They've driven the lane on, really not driven the lane, but they've handled the ball on rebounds and gone underneath with that ball. But they've not really driven the lane much. It's been outside shooting thanks to the hard pressure from the Patriots. Slip it underneath to a cutting Scarlett Gilmore. Like that move. Scarlett Gilmore hangs out over at the three-point line and then drives underneath the rim. She's wide open there. Takes the ball, lays it in with her left hand. So the Patriots, after being down 20-13, have closed the gap. Possession to Newberry. Patriots are within three. 7:08 to go in the second quarter. 5 on the shot clock. Holly Davies is going to throw one up. It does hit the rim, but that's an errant stroke from Holly Davies. Possession back to the Patriots with a chance to tie or close within one. Anaya Oliver back out on the floor. Point guard, regular point guard for the Patriots. Work it over to Lee, then to Richards. A lot of outside work there for the Patriots. Good rebound from Kiana Lee. Lee's going to take it up to the rim. Jasmine Stanley cannot collect the rebound. Excellent rebound by number 20, Ella Pearson for Newberry. Wide open tray, opportunity from Peyton Cronin. She knocks down the tray. So Cronin with her second three-pointer of the day. She is now 2 for 3 from extra point land. Newberry with a 23-17 lead, 6:18 to go here in this second quarter. Janiyah Haygood into the game, also Lauren Taylor. Anaya Oliver with the inbound. No problem there. Scarlett Gilmore receives the inbound pass back to Oliver. Scarlett Gilmore with the Euro step from almost near the three-point line. That did not generate the shot that she wanted. Rebound to Bongiorno and the Wolves. Bongiorno driving in, draws the foul against Janiyah Haygood. Haygood was defending nicely, but Bongiorno really charging in smartly with all of the momentum to get the score. She'll have an opportunity for the and one. She did knock down that lay-in. So Bongiorno at the line, already the leading scorer for Newberry. She has 7. Make it 8 with that free throw. Possession now to the Patriots. Patriots find themselves down by 9, the best advantage for Newberry so far this evening. Oliver is getting trapped. There's Haygood. Over to Oliver. So working that perimeter are the Patriots, trying to free up Scarlett Gilmore. It'll be a foul on the floor. Erica Wisely. So that's going to be Wisely's second foul. I'll probably see Wisely come out here momentarily. Nope. Yes, in fact, Wisely is going to come off of the floor. Newberry retains the length, though. Kiana Lee with an errant shot. That ball goes against the rim. A scramble for the ball. Patriots get the ball. Anaya Oliver is going to slow things down. Scar Gilmore at the three-point line decides to slip it underneath to Lauren Taylor. Taylor misses the knockdown underneath the rim, but she's going to get 2 opportunities at a stroke. So Rummery Lamb charged with defending. She does get the foul. And I think for Rummery Lamb, if she's going to foul, she likes the fact that she prevented the bucket from Taylor, forces Taylor to go to the line. Sure enough, Taylor misses the front end of the 2 strokes. 5:13 to go. Newberry with a 9-point lead. 2 misses for Lauren Taylor from the free throw stripe. Newberry's Bongiorno calling out the play. Bongiorno is going to handle the ball nicely against the defense of Janiyah Haygood. Pop it out to Holly Davies. Davies had an opportunity underneath, went maybe a little bit slow. Rummery Lamb with the dribble, turn and skyhook to knock it down. Rummery Lamb knows what she needs to do in this match. At 6'4", her job is to get underneath the rim and shoot over anybody defending her. Quality pressure from Newberry at that full court. Patriots now underneath is Lauren Taylor. This time Taylor gets the and one. She'll go to the charity stripe for 1. Newberry up 28-19. 4:25 to go here in the second quarter. 9 points continues to be the largest lead for the Newberry Wolves. Taylor misses the free throw. Reaching in to get the ball is Tyler Stolberg. And Kiana Lee got the last touch on that one. So Stolberg with the effort. Touched then by Lee, which means possession to Newberry. Newberry set up really in a 1-2-2 to start their offense. Excellent defense from Scarlett Gilmore, reaching in to deflect the pass. Whipping it around the perimeter is Newberry. More quality defense from Kiana Lee. She can't corral the steal. Possession back to Newberry. How about the three-pointer from Peyton Cronin? Cronin now has knocked down three three-pointers in this half to get this game going. So Cronin leading all scorers for Newberry. She has 9 points, all of those on three-pointers. So she's three for four from the arc today. Haggard's going to go ahead and take it to the hole. Excellent work by the Patriots to clear out, allowing for Haggard to have a little bit of room to maneuver. She takes it to the rim, puts it up with no problem for the bucket. Count it for Haggard. Newberry's Peyton Cronin handles it at the point. Now the Patriots are going to get a little bit closer to Cronin after three-pointers in a row. So instead, Newberry works it around for a different bucket from a different player. Breaking the press is Anaya Oliver and the Patriots squad. Lauren Taylor with the ball. She'll flip it back to Oliver. Oliver to Scarlett Gilmore, trying to get hot. This time, all three of these. Count it, the tray for Scarlett Gilmore. Gilmore had been trying to knock down that tray. Missed a couple earlier on in this stanza. This time, her shot is true. FMU remains within 9. More hard work and charged up defense from Scarlett Gilmore. Gilmore knocks it down on the other end, then gets a quality defense against Newberry, so possession of the Patriots. Like that effort from Gilmore. Gilmore is going to hang back and help out against the pressing Newberry Wolves. Nia Oliver is going to get the ball over to Kiana Lee. Key Lee to Stanley. Stanley to Gilmore. Gilmore is going to try it again. This time, not so much. Rebound to Lee. Lee can't corral it. There goes Newberry on the run. Love this run. What a fantastic pass from Holly Davies. However, Newberry can't finish the deal. It's going to be a foul then against Holly Davies. Holly Davies looks over at the official and says, "That's not a foul." Well, our official contends otherwise. So 2:04 to go here in the quarter. The Newberry College Wolves remain up by 9. So Lauren Taylor back out on the floor. Joining her is Haygood, along with Richards, Stanley, and Anaya Oliver at the line. Anaya Oliver, last year from free throw line, she was a 7.23 average from the free throw line with 101 attempts on the season. So quality free throw shooter, they are 1 for 2. Patriots will just have to settle for getting back on defense. Holly Davies has a dribble to give. She does so. Davies now ready to get back to it. She's between the circles. Flick it over to number 14, Mercer Roberts, back on the floor. Count the three. Three attempt from Rummery Lamb. Lamb's miss. Rummery Lamb's miss is off the mark. Rebound to the Patriots. Nia Oliver slip it down to Lauren Stanley. Stanley with a travel. Stanley got pretty excited on that one when she knew she had position and possession of the ball. She did juggle those feet, therefore the immediate travel call. Possession back to Newberry. Newberry 33-25 here with 1:32 to go here in the second quarter. Davies is going to give it up on the sideline to Newberry's number 31, Peyton Cronin. Cronin again knocks it down. Well, Cronin with the hot hand for Newberry. Cronin and Newberry with Cronin with now 11 points on the day. That her first two-pointer, her other points on three-pointers. Foul on the floor. That's going to be against Faith Putz. So Faith Putz, the Des Moines, Iowa transfer coming in from Kansas City Community College. Also on the team is Mercer Roberts coming in from Kansas City Community College. So two teammates from the same junior college for Newberry out on the floor today for the black and red. As for the red, white, and blue Patriots, Anaya Oliver at the line. two misses, very rare two misses in a row for her. Normally pretty true from the free throw line. However, rebound of the Patriots. Offensive rebound off of those free throw at that last free throw attempt. Unfortunate error for the Patriots. Patriots need to be a little bit more patient in that situation with the much longer defending Newberry in front of them. Handling the ball, Faith Putz. Swing it over to April Rummery-Lamb. Rummery-Lamb, the lengthy 6'4" center, is going to handle the ball all the way to the rim. There's the miss. Rebound for the Patriots. Reach in foul on Lauren Taylor. So Taylor's going to get the call. Oh, and scratch that. That's going to be a foul against Newberry. I thought certain it was a reach-in foul on the Patriots. Instead, credit the Patriots for their effort. It will be Rummery-Lamb with the foul. Bonus time is Lauren Taylor at the line. 10-point lead for Newberry College. Count the first, make it 9. The Patriots want to keep this at least within single digits against the hot shooting of Peyton Cronin. Peyton Cronin, fantastic shooting, resulting in 11 of Newberry's 35 points. Lauren Taylor knocking down both of her free throws. Turn off the shot clock, 18 seconds to go in the quarter. Oh, that's the double dribble. That one is pretty obvious, and I appreciate the honesty from Tyler Stahlberg. She looks at her hands and says, man, what did I do with that ball? She had the double dribble. She knows it. Therefore, give up the ball. Possession of the Patriots. Now 10 seconds to go. Newberry 35-27. Handling the ball is Haygood. Steal from Davies. Davies is going to have time to lay it in for the final bucket of the quarter. Newberry with a 37-27 lead as we close out the second quarter. So we're going to take a break here at the University Center where the Newberry Wolves lead 37-27. Let's take about 5 to 8 minutes, take a break. We'll hear from our sponsors, and then we'll come back and give you a recap on the first half, and we'll talk a little bit about what the Patriots need to do to get back into this one. Thanks for joining us on the FM Patriot Network.
Conference Carolinas is where tradition is unmatched, and excellence is earned daily in the classroom, during practice, and in high-level competition.
Tigerville has become Title Town.
Our virtues set us apart. We daily work to build champions in body, mind, and soul. It's who we are. This is Conference Carolinas.
If you had to pause your favorite show because your spouse fell asleep, you've compromised enough. Pepsi Zero Sugar.
Year after year, with unwavering dedication, McLeod Health has stood shoulder to shoulder with families, friends, and neighbors, bringing healthcare expertise and compassion to all the communities we serve. As the region's most trusted healthcare resource, our physicians are here for you. Our nurses are here for you. The entire McLeod family is here for you. McLeod Health, here for life.
So many flavors of dew. I am thirsty. I must get the dew.
Cut, cut! He's hypnotized again!
Do the dew.
Francis Marion University provided me opportunity in basketball and education. After graduation, I played professionally and started my own business. Today, I'm an assistant admissions director helping the next generation of Patriots. Because an education at Francis Marion opens doors to a world of opportunities. Well, my baby
dove gives me special love. It's the kind of stuff. Honey, it's your turn. I'm on cloud nine.
Pizza, better with Pepsi.
Where can you find Francis Marion University? Are we at our ever-expanding main campus? Or at the new Freshwater Ecology Center? In our theaters, galleries, and classrooms in downtown Florence? Or with the growing list of partners throughout the state? We're all of those places. And we're with every one of our 26,000 graduates. Francis Marion University. We're everywhere.
This one is for every parent who needs a vacation after getting back from a family vacation. You've compromised enough. Pepsi Zero Sugar.
Huh?
Burgers, better with Pepsi.
Conference Carolinas is where tradition is unmatched and excellence is earned daily in the classroom, during practice, and in high-level competition.
Tigerville has become Titletown.
Our virtues set us apart. We daily work to build champions in body, mind, and soul. It's who we are. This is Conference Carolinas.
If you had to pause your favorite show because your spouse fell asleep, you've compromised enough. Pepsi Zero Sugar.
Year after year, with unwavering dedication, McLeod Health has stood shoulder to shoulder with families, friends, and neighbors, bringing healthcare expertise and compassion to all the communities we serve. As the region's most trusted healthcare resource, our physicians are here for you. Our nurses are here for you. The entire McLeod family is here for you. McLeod Health, here for life.
So many flavors of dew. I am thirsty. I must get a dew.
Cut, cut! He's hypnotized again!
Do the dew.
Francis Marion University provided me opportunity in basketball and education. After graduation, I played professionally and started my own business. Today, I'm an assistant admissions director, helping the next generation of patriots. Because an education at Francis Marion opens doors to a world of opportunities. Well, my baby
dove gives me special love. It's the kind of stuff. Honey, it's your turn. I'm on cloud nine.
Pizza, better with Pepsi.
Where can you find Francis Marion University? Are we at our ever-expanding main campus? Or at the new Freshwater Ecology Center? In our theaters, galleries, and classrooms in downtown Florence? Or with the growing list of partners throughout the state? We're all of those places. And we're with every one of our 26,000 graduates. Francis Marion University. We're everywhere.
This one is for every parent who needs a vacation after getting back from a family vacation. You've compromised enough. Pepsi Zero Sugar.
Huh?
Burgers, better with Pepsi.
Welcome back to the Smith University Center, where Newberry College, the away squad, holds a 37-27 advantage after two quarters of play. Really, the tail of the tape is the defense of Newberry College. Of course, they stacked the stat sheet to the tune of 10 points more than the Pats. However, six steals, two each from Holly Davies and Julia Bongiorno, are really the difference in this matchup to the Patriots. Zero steals yet, and those steals have resulted in tallies for Newberry. Let's get into some highlights for first for your Patriots. Leading the way for the Pats, 8 points for Lauren Taylor. She was 4-for-7 from the free throw stripe, made a couple from the field. Scarlett Gilmore right behind her with 7 points. Spreading around the assists category, 6 assists, 2 credited to Anaya Oliver, 4 others with 1 assist each. So the Patriots really struggling from the field, hitting at a 31% clip on the day overall. But as for Newberry College, how about hitting 1 in every 2 of their strokes? Yes, hitting at a 50% clip are the Newberry Wolves. And from the 3-point arc, 4-for-9, they are hitting at a 44% clip. Credit 3 of the 4 made 3-pointers to Peyton Cronin. Peyton Cronin leads all scorers on the day. Number 31, Cronin, with 11 points on the day. But then you gotta give a ton of credit to Julia Bongiorno. Bongiorno has handled the ball as both the one from the point position and also She's been playing the ball as a two, allowing Holly Davies to handle the point guard duties. So Davies and Buongiorno really handling the ball, bringing the ball up the court, getting the offense started for Newberry. Buongiorno with 6 assists on the day, 8 points to her credit. She also leads the squad in rebounds. She has 4. Holly Davies and Erica Wisely with 3. But Wisely in some foul trouble early. She had 2 fouls against her early on, so she saw sparing time in the second quarter. 2 fouls against Erica Wisely, Rummery Lamb, and also Diani Burke. Burke in only 4 minutes plus of play with those 2 fouls. For the Patriots, they're really going to have to get things going on the offensive end. They are hitting at a 31% clip and only 20% from the 3-point arc. That's just not going to get it done against a quality Newberry team who also has demonstrated that it can rebound fantastically. Their length, a big problem. Erica Wisely, 6'2" on the glass. April Rummery Lamb getting in on the glass work. She's 6'4". Then mix in the guard getting some rebounds in Buongiorno. You have an advantage on the Newberry Wolves side from a rebounding standpoint that cannot be beat. I'd like to thank our sponsors before we get started with the third quarter. FMU Athletics would like to thank the following: Adidas, Circle Park Behavioral Health Services, McLeod Regional Medical Center, Ken Jackson and Remax Professionals, Pepsi, McDonald's, Rains Hospitality, including Fairfield Inn, Spring Hill Suites, Courtyard by Marriott, Comfort Inn and Hyatt Place, King Cadillac Buick GMC, McLeod Sports Medicine, Chick-fil-A, Quincy's Steakhouse, Little Caesars, La Quinta Inn and Suites, KFC Arby's, Waffle House, Sparrow and Kennedy Tractor Supply, McCall's Supply Incorporated, Western Sizzlin' Steakhouse, State Credit Union, and Zaxby's. And with all of those food sponsors, firstly, we thank all of our sponsors for FMU Athletics, but naming all those food sponsors, boy, I'm just a little bit hungry right now as we get ready to kick off the third quarter, as are the Patriots, hungry to chomp into this lead. Newberry with a 10-point advantage as we attempt to get things started here in the third quarter. Please note, the 2022-23 Conference Carolinas Championship season is coming soon. Please visit conferencecarolinas.com/championships to learn more about all of the 22-23 Conference Carolinas Championships. So we're prepping to get started. It'll be the inbound of Scarlett Gilmore. She'll kick it in, presumably, to Anaya Oliver. Defending Oliver is Holly Davies, awaiting the ball to come in. Also on the floor, Peyton Cronin. So two guards awaiting on defense here at the half court as we prepare to kick off the third quarter. Patriots spreading the floor. Out on the floor is Lauren Taylor. Also mix in Kiana Lee, Jasmine Stanley, and the aforementioned guards in Anaya Oliver, Scarlett Gilmore.
All right, fans, let's get ready. Second half action.
And the inbound, and we are underway here in the third quarter. Newberry with a 10-point advantage to start things off the second half of play. Lauren Taylor slips it underneath. Back out to Kiana Lee. Lee will flip it out. Stanley to Gilmore. Gilmore, 2 dribbles over to Oliver with the tray attempt. Rebound to Key Lee. Excellent work from Kiana Lee on that rebound. Well positioned is she. Gilmore drive and kick to Kiana Lee. Lee with the teardrop. 2 on the teardrop for Kiana Lee. Kiana Lee with the first points of the third quarter. Patriots remain down by 8. Possession out of Newberry College. Possession arrow is Newberry. Moving the ball around the perimeter, Erica Wisely now. Wisely smartly handles the ball down into the paint. Buongiorno now at the top. Buongiorno with the slight elbow stroke Rebounded nicely by Kiana Lee. Lee over to Stanley. Oliver will get things started on the elbow. Oliver with the turn and gun from 20 feet on the baseline. She gets it to go. 4 quick points for the Patriots to start the third quarter. Newberry now underneath, no problem with the slip. Wisely, smartly underneath. She is living up to her name with her rebounding and also her skill underneath the rim. Scarlett Gilmore on her own breaks the press of Newberry. Newberry continues to press the full court. They have done that all match. Meanwhile, the Patriots have been content to sit back in their half-court defense. Stanley out to Gilmore. Gilmore takes the tray attempt. No go from Milgamore. Gilmore is going to step in and try for the steal. Reaches in on Julia Bongiorno. So that'll be a foul on the floor, inbound for Newberry. Newberry with an 8-point advantage and the ball on possession. 8 minutes to go here. We are early on in the third quarter. Both squads coming in at 0-2 on the season, so both trying to notch their first victory. Patriots rebound. Long stretch to Gilmore. 70-foot pass to Gilmore. Gilmore makes no mistake. Puts it on the floor one time, then the lay-in. Missed shot. Anaya Oliver putting pressure on down underneath the rim. Rebound for the Patriots. Foul underneath. That's going to be against Wisely. Wisely staring at foul trouble. Wisely with her third foul of the game. So April Rummery Lamb will come into the game for Newberry. Rummery Lamb with 4 points in the first half to go along with another rebound. So another bucket for the Patriots is going to prompt a media timeout. And that's a timeout for Newberry. We'll go to the media timeout. We'll take it with them. Newberry with a 39-35 lead.
Year after year, with unwavering dedication, McLeod Health has stood shoulder to shoulder with families, friends, and neighbors, bringing healthcare expertise and compassion to all the communities we serve. As the region's most trusted healthcare resource, our physicians are here for you. Our nurses are here for you. The entire McLeod family is here for you. McLeod Health, here for life.
If you had to pause your favorite show because your spouse fell asleep, you've compromised enough. Pepsi Zero Sugar.
So Newberry up by one, 39-38. Apologies for the sound error there on my part. So Patriots have closed the gap, 39-38. Now is Newberry. Stanley looking to go to the line and take the lead or even take the advantage on the Patriots side. So Jasmine Stanley to the line. Just off the back rim. Coach Jerry Porter nodding her head saying, hey, when it's time to tie things up, we've got to get the job done. Stanley, a very experienced free throw shooter for the Patriots, but there with the miss was Jasmine Stanley. Stanley, 684 free throw shooter last season. And it'll be another foul on the floor against Newberry. Mercer Roberts with the foul against, so another possession to the Patriots. Inbounding is Anaya Oliver into Scarlett Gilmore. She had a look, but she decided against it. I like her hesitation there. Now she's going to get the look she wants. All three of these. Count that, Trey. How about an FMU lead? FMU was down by 10 to start the third. 6:33 to go in the third. Patriots have taken a one-point advantage. Holly Davies with the ball at the point. She's going to go ahead and throw a three-point of her own, and she gets hers to go. Good answer by Holly Davies to get the job done there from the three-point arc. So Scarlett Gilmore is going to bring the ball up over to Kiana Lee. Three guards in Lee, Gilmore, and Anaya Oliver. Trey attempt from Lauren Stanley is missed. Rebound attempt from Scarlett Gilmore, no good. Possession to Newberry. Oh, it's another three. This time Marin Roberts with the three. Scratch that, Mercer Roberts. Anaya Oliver with a shake and bake underneath, getting it done. How about the lay-in for Anaya Oliver? Coast to coast, Oliver went, took care of the business there to take advantage. Well, now we're going to go back and forth a little bit. Newberry with only a two-point advantage. Patriots defense has been energized here as we have started the third quarter. Flip it under to Rummery Lamb. Lamb's going to have her way underneath. Defending is Lauren Taylor. Here comes the Patriots on the run. Scarlett Gilmore is going to go Euro step. She ran out of gas underneath the rim. Possession and numbers for Newberry. Oh, quality stop from the Patriots. So Holly Davies got possession. And we're going to get a timeout on the floor. Injury out on the floor. When we come back, we'll get a update for you as to how things are going. We're going to take a break. Newberry with a two-point lead. It's 44-42.
Where can you find Francis Marion University? Are we at our ever-expanding main campus? Or at the new Freshwater Ecology Center? In our theaters, galleries, and classrooms in downtown Florence? Or with the growing list of partners throughout the state? We're all of those places. And we're with every one of our 26,000 graduates. Francis Marion University. We're everywhere.
This one is for every parent who needs a vacation after getting back from a family vacation. You've compromised enough. Pepsi Zero Sugar.
We'll be right back.
thirsty. I must get the dew.
Cut! Cut! He's hypnotized again!
Do the dew.
Welcome back out of that injury timeout. Anaya Oliver off the floor, going for the steal, seems to have injured an elbow or a wrist. We'll get you an update if we can get it later on today. Buongiorno now with the three-point stroke. Rebound to Newberry. Going up and over is Mercer Roberts. She draws the foul. Mercer Roberts is going to go to the line. That'll be a foul against Jada Richards. Richards nearly got all ball, but she did get a little bit of body on Mercer Roberts. So Roberts to the line. Roberts true on her first free throw. She makes the second. More press from Newberry. Patriots are able to break that press. They make it up into their half-court offense. 20 seconds to go on the shot clock. 4 and 11 to go in this third stanza. Newberry with a four-point lead. Slipping up and under and up is Lauren Taylor for another bucket. Patriots desperately need for Taylor to get hot if they are to spell the length of Newberry. It's going to be a foul on Trinity and Adams. And it's been a very consistent call today. Both squads getting called for touch fouls on either side. No surprise there that that one's going to be called. Dayani Burke with the inbound. Buongiorno handles the ball out at the arc. She's going to go ahead and take it inside, kick it out. Burke with the miss. It's going to be over the back on the defensive side, attempting for an offensive rebound. Buongiorno with the over the back call. So back into the game for Newberry is Holly Davies, and of course Kiana Lee will go to the line for the Patriots. Kiana Lee last season, 797 from the charity stripe. Picks up where she left off last season. She's one for one from the line on this opportunity. FMU closes to within one, 341 to go in the third quarter. Second one's a miss, rebound to Newberry. Mercer Roberts brought down the ball off of the glass. So Holly Davies handles the ball for Newberry. Good defense on the side of the Patriots. Forcing a Rummery Lamb shot from 20 feet, and Patriots will give up that shot to Rummery Lamb any day. The result was a miss and the rebound to the Patriots. Trinity Davis with a miss. Rebound for the Patriots. Penalty against Kiana Lee. Kiana Lee with a little bit of elbow action, trying to create some space as she gets back to the glass. Cherry Porter not too happy about that. Johnette Walker exceptionally unhappy with that call. They make it known to the officials. Generally, that coaching staff is not going to get too vociferous against the referees. Their sportsmanship is exemplary for the Patriots. It has been for years. Rebound for the Patriots. Holly Davies on the miss. Coming in is Malia Owens. Richards is going to drive. Screen from Kiana Lee. Trinity Adams is going to go to the hole. Flip it over to Key Lee. This time Richards from three. All three of these for Jada Richards. Getting in on the arc action. Excellent stroke by her. FMU now with a two-point advantage. Two-point advantage, 221 out on the floor to go in the third. Love that stroke from Jada Richards. I had a great view of that. Gotta tell you, from here, that was always online. Jada Richards with all three of those. We're gonna get a timeout on the floor from Newberry. 221 to go. Patriots with a two-point lead. Welcome back to the Smith University Center. It's 2:21 to go in the third quarter. FMU found itself down by 10, 37-27 in the third quarter. But the Patriots now with a two-point lead, 2:19 to go here in this third quarter. 16 to go on the shot clock, plenty of time for Newberry. Working it from the point is Erica Wisely, from out the top of the arc, I should say. Work it down to Wisely. Fans of the Patriots are really thrilled with the defense that has gotten on track on this particular quarter, starting to slow the Newberry offense. How about the three from, or 2 points for Lauren Taylor? So Taylor got a couple of steps look, so she says, hey, I'll take the baseline 10-footer, knocks it down, FMU with a four-point advantage. Wisely's gonna elbow her way through, muscle her way in from underneath. Holly Davies gets the rebound, but then she steps out of bounds while trying to corral it and get the offense going. So turn it over, give it back to the Patriots. 1:36 to go here in the third. FMU with a 50-46 advantage. Full court press is broken again by the Patriots. Trinity Adams handles the ball with ease. It'll be Malaya Owens now handling business as Anaya Oliver out after an apparent injury to either her elbow or wrist, going for a steal earlier in this quarter. Rebound to Newberry. This time the shot from Cronin. Another tray from Cronin. Cronin with three threes in the first half to account for 9 of her 11 first half points. Give her another tray here in the third, she's got 14. Lauren Taylor gets her own rebound, gets another rebound. Taylor will not be denied the rebound. Problem is, she couldn't get that ball in. So she had that ball over her head. I know what she wanted to do. I know what I would want to do. I'd want to slam that down, but she has good control, decides not to do it, prompting, which would have prompted a technical foul. So instead, possession back to Newberry. Like that self-control from Lauren Taylor. That's just what an experienced player is supposed to do, is play steady, play for the next possession. And Richards is gonna get called for the touch foul against Julia Bongiorno. So Bongiorno is gonna go to the line. 37.8 seconds to go here in the third. FMU with a 50-49 advantage. Coming into the game for Newberry will be Faith Putz, the guard from Des Moines, Iowa. So definitely a defensive substitution after the Bongiorno free throw. Bongiorno knocks down one. We are deadlocked at 50. Fans do not like the touch foul, resulting in the penalty and the free throws from Bongiorno. Bongiorno 1-for-2 during that opportunity. Patriots have the ball. Only a 5-second differential on the shot clock. Make it a 6-point. Trinity Adams is going to take it all the way to the hole. She's denied by number 23, Bongiorno. Bongiorno everywhere, all over the floor for Newberry, making her presence known. All the way from Rome, Italy, coming to the Midlands of South Carolina to play basketball, and she is certainly having a good matchup so far today. Holly Davies with the air ball on the three. 1 second to go. It'll be a shot from Kiana Lee from about 80 feet to no avail. FMU erases a 10-point advantage at the half. Newberry up. Patriots now deadlocked with Newberry. 50 apiece as we wrapped up the third. Cannot wait for this exciting fourth quarter to ensue. Both squads looking for their first victory of the season. When we get back, fourth quarter action here at the Smith University Center.
Where can you find Francis Marion University? Are we at our ever-expanding main campus? Or at the new Freshwater Ecology Center? In our theaters, galleries, and classrooms in downtown Florence? Or with the growing list of partners throughout the state? We're all of those places. And we're with every one of our 26,000 graduates. Francis Marion University. We're everywhere.
This one is for every parent who needs a vacation after getting back from a family vacation. You've compromised enough. Pepsi Zero Sugar.
Ailing out there. Now the ball to Jasmine Stanley. Stick it underneath Stanley for two. Defense. Holly Davies brings the ball up. It'll be Deanna Burke. Burke with the give and go. Now at the elbow.
Rebound.
Burke with the high glass and an away town rim bouncer that falls. Newberry with their first points of the fourth quarter. 9:15 to go here in the fourth. We just got started, and Anaya Oliver out for most of the third with what was an apparent injury. She is now back out in action handling the point guard duties for the Patriots. So I like that toughness from her. She was out momentarily, clearly in some pain. She's been cleared by the training staff of the Patriots to get back at it. In the meantime, Scarlett Gilmore is going to go to the line. And every point so important here in the fourth quarter for Gilmore. Bit of a hit or miss day for her. She now leads the squad. She is tied for the points lead with 14, but her points definitely come in spurts. That's not much different than last season when she will score big time in a quarter, then go silent for another, then get hot for another stretch. Of course, Coach Jerry Porter hoping that she gets hot here in the fourth quarter. So travel from Newberry. Possession back to the Patriots. Joanna Tincher, coach for Newberry, Francis Marion graduate, not too happy with that play. She stands up in dismay saying, hey, you gotta settle yourself if you're gonna set your feet. Patriots now in control. Handling the ball is Jada Richards. Working the perimeter for Anaya Oliver. Oliver's gonna go to the hole. High glasser, doesn't quite go. Rebound to Jasmine Stanley. Stanley to Richards, good work by Stanley to corral that ball and get the ball back for another possession. High glass, a bit out of control is Scarlett Gilmore. She slaps her hand. She's a little bummed out at that shot. I don't blame her. Think she'd like to have that one back. Wisely would not want to have that one back. She wants that one just the way it went. Wisely works that ball underneath, so instead of working a possession game, this time Newberry gets it down to Wisely. Wisely gets the ball to go. Missed three-pointer, rebounded by Richards. out to Kiana Lee. Kiana decides to drive the lane. She's going to get called for the foul. So Kiana Lee back to the line. Foul against Newberry. So coming back in after some rest is Bongiorno. I don't expect Bongiorno off the floor pretty much for the rest of the game. Bongiorno is all rebounds, all scoring, and handles much of the point guard duties for Newberry. I think she'll see most of those 7 and 51 of this last fourth quarter. So Kiana Lee knocks it down. She's going to come out for a breather herself. So Coach Jerry Porter managing the minutes to make sure that her top dogs are fresh as they get ready for the final stretch. Defending is Bongiorno. Bongiorno being defended by Richards. Richards with a little bit of contact on Bongiorno. No foul called. Slip it under to Wisely. Wisely up and over for the basket. Like that work by Wisely, she found herself free, was able to get the pass from Bongiorno, take the ball down the lane, one dribble and up and in. And there's Lauren Taylor. Taylor's gonna go up and in. So Lauren Taylor gets the and one opportunity. FMU with a 2-point advantage, looking to stretch it to three. Gotta tell you, Newberry was starting to pull away at the end of the second quarter, up by 10 and looking good. Since then, it's been all Patriots. Rebound to Newberry. It'll be Bongiorno handling the ball at the point in between the circles. And the Patriot faithful want to carry, but in this day and age, that will never be called. Defense by the Patriots and a steal. Anaya Oliver is going to try to take it herself. Nope, she slips it underneath at the last second to Stanley. Smart work by Oliver to draw the defense over to Stanley. Stanley with the lay-in. 6:36 to go. Patriots by four, looking to D up against Bongiorno. Bongiorno with the shake and bake. Lauren Taylor's going to try to pick her up. Bongiorno slips past Lauren Taylor, does it all on her own, takes it to the rim, gets the bucket. Anaya Oliver is going to slide over to the coaching staff and say, hey, do you want to give me a play, give me a timeout? Coach Jerry Porter is content to allow Anaya Oliver to make the call. Air ball, Jada Richards. Richards was trying to get hot a little bit earlier. Peyton Cronin, the sharpshooter, back out on the floor for Newberry. Can't say enough about Peyton Cronin. Cronin with 14 points leads Newberry. She is 4 for 5 from the arc. And that'll be a foul against the Patriots. Number 11, Anaya Oliver, with a little shoulder shiver, putting pressure on Newberry, but it'll be Newberry with the foul and possession on the inbound. Bongiorno whipped around to Cronin, back to Bongiorno. Bongiorno's gonna think about taking it herself. This time, not enough room. How about Rummery Lamb? Rummery Lamb is gonna get number one, Trinity Adams, to step back. Rummery Lamb then with the teardrop 4-foot stroke. How about a 3-point stroke? All three of these for Lauren Taylor. She just decides to pull up and knock it down. How about that tray for the Patriots? 5:18 to go. FMU with a 3-point lead. Newberry in possession. Diane Burke handles the ball. It'll be a travel against Anaya Oliver. So possession back to Newberry. So we come down to the home stretch, about halfway through this fourth quarter. FMU with a slim 3-point lead. Diani Burke to inbound. Inbounds to Bongiorno. Bongiorno decides to take it out to the top. Now down the sideline. Rummery Lamb. How about the rebound by the Patriots? So the missed tray by Ella Pearson is stopped. How about another three attempt from Lauren Stanley? This time Kiana Lee is going to go ahead and handle the ball. Oliver to Lee. Lee is going to throw up that three-pointer hard off the rim. Just a little too strong. This time the jump ball. Lauren Stanley, Ella Pearson. We're going to get a media timeout. 4:36 to go. We're coming down the home stretch. FMU leads 63-60.
Francis Marion University provided me opportunity in basketball and education. After graduation, I played professionally and started my own business. Today, I'm an assistant admissions director helping the next generation of Patriots. Because an education at Francis Marion opens doors to a world of opportunities.
Dude.
Fire.
Grillmaster, huh?
Burgers, better with Pepsi.
Conference Carolinas is committed to aligning with businesses that share our common values and, like us, strive to attain excellence and virtue in all endeavors. We work hard to make our corporate partnerships a truly beneficial relationship through mutually agreed upon customization that will lead to unparalleled exposure. Conference Carolinas would love to thank our current corporate partners, Barnes & Noble College, Bufkin & Baker, Cambria Hotel Greenville, Championship Award Guys, Digital Scoreboards by Fermetco, Herf Jones, Hometown Ticketing, Our-A-Thon, Huddle, Marriott Spartanburg, McGriff Insurance Services, McMillan Pasden Smith Plus Incorporated, Score Shots, SCS by Floor, Action Incorporated. So rebound to the Patriots after an errant three-point attempt from Peyton Cronin. Cronin had been hot from Trey. She has knocked down four on the day. Lauren Taylor, as hot as well from the paint. She works her way in, but it's going to be a foul, offensive foul against Lauren Taylor. A little bit too much muscle from Lauren Taylor. So 4:06 to go. FMU 63, Newberry 60. So bringing up the ball is Bongiorno. Bongiorno got a bit of a rest early on in the fourth, so I believe we will see Bongiorno for the rest of this game. How about the steal from Kiana Lee? Taking it to the rim. She gets it done. How about two of those? FMU's greatest lead of the game at 5 points. Steal in the finish from Kiana Lee. More possession give and go is Newberry. Rushing it is Newberry. Now the Patriots, Anaya Oliver, are going to handle things. Underneath to Stanley. Count it from Stanley. Holly Davies tried to defend but couldn't do it. Davies was on the move. Lauren Stanley took a tour and gets the finish, prompting the Newberry timeout. FMU with its biggest lead of the game, prompting timeout from the Newberry Wolves. FMU 67, Newberry 60 with 3:24 to go. Welcome back to Florence, South Carolina, here at the Smith University Center. This is the home opener for women's basketball for Francis Marion. Francis Marion has stormed out to a 67-60 advantage. At the end of the half, it was Newberry 37, Francis Marion 27. But since then, a 17-point advantage for the Patriots opens up to a 7-point lead for the Pats. This time a forearm foul from Bongiorno Bongiorno trying to do it all on her own, but instead it's going to be the offensive foul. So Bongiorno is going to come out of the game. In to spell her is Faith Putz. Faith Putz is going to take on the guard duties along with Holly Davies out on the floor defending Anaya Oliver. Anaya Oliver with a little shake and bake, working her way into the paint. Easy steal from Ella Pearson, getting into the passing lane. Holly Davies makes a mistake and tosses it out of bounds on the Newberry bench. 3:01 tick of the clock remaining from the Patriots' first victory of the season. They lead 67-60. Now Oliver with a flip overhead to Kiana Lee. Oliver back to the paint. This time Oliver, teardrop, count it. Patriots with a 9-point advantage. Holly Davies between the circles over to Cronin. They need Cronin to get hot. She has been a 3-point machine. How about the underhand from Erica Wisely? Her only open lane was to go underhanded, so she does so. She's played her share of horse in the backyard in her younger days. That was clearly a horse shot. Good shot for her by Wisely to cut into the Patriots' lead. To Stanley at the top of the free throw circle. Over to Oliver. 9 on the shot clock, make it 8. Oliver is going to work her way to the elbow. Falling back on the miss. Rebound, Lauren Stanley. Working the clock is Oliver. 2 minutes to go in this fourth quarter. FMU with a 7-point advantage. Oliver to Lee. Lee is thinking about the drive. She's going to dribble down the lane and handle things. Kiana Lee takes the advantage to 9 points for the Pats. Patriots closing in on their first victory of the season. They're going to have to work hard to get that done. A quick answer by Newberry. Newberry has closed within 7. We are nearing the 1 minute mark of the fourth quarter. 1 minute. Kiana Lee handles the ball back to Anaya Oliver. Patriots content to work the shot clock down to 7 and 6. Jasmine Stanley's gonna go ahead and throw one up. I think she didn't realize she had a little bit more time than she thought. Foul against the Patriots. So an unwise foul from Jada Richards. Jada Richards would have been wise just to force Newberry to work the ball up. Instead, the foul stops the clock. Wholesale changes for Newberry. Bongiorno back onto the floor. Bongiorno had a spell of giveaways. Patriots content to force Bongiorno to dribble, taking more time off the clock. Wisely with another underhander. This time Wisely's ball is not successful. Gilmore scrappily goes for the ball. And it'll be a foul against Newberry. And the fans are getting excited to sing the goodbye song, but there's a lot of game to be played here. So Scarlett Gilmore goes to the line. With 30.6 to go, Patriots closing in on their first victory of the season. Count the seconds, so the Patriots up by 8. We'll see the inbound from Newberry. A little bit of pressure from the Patriots, just trying to slow the dribble of Newberry. This is the first amount of press, and the Patriots are going to press and cause the foul, stopping the clock, putting Newberry, and they did have one foul to give, scratch that. So Keanu Lee not too happy about that foul, but they knew they had one foul to give. They could put that kind of pressure on. Bongiorno's going to throw the three. That's what she has to do, but that's an air ball. That ball's going to go out of bounds. Shut off the shot clock. 21 seconds to go. It'll be a foul against Newberry. Of course, they're going to stop the clock every moment they can. Put FMU at the line. It'll be Anaya Oliver at the line for the Patriots. Patriots with an 8-point lead. Newberry is going to foul at every turn with the hopes of getting back, knocking down a tray, and hopefully closing the gap. Patriots opening up a big lead here in the second, in the fourth quarter. Patriots found themselves down 37-27 after two stanzas. After that, it's been all Patriots. Get the back end of two is Anaya Oliver, making a 9-point lead. Wisely's going to go ahead to the rim. Possession of the Patriots. Newberry's going to take off the defense. Congrats to the Patriots, their first victory of the 2022 season. Patriots move to 1-2 on the season. Newberry falls to 0-3. Newberry back in action at Pembroke on November 19th. As for the Patriots, Patriots will return to action. They are at Fayetteville State on November 19th. They return home Tuesday against Shawan University to open Conference Carolina's play. Let's give you a quick update and a review of these statistics for the Patriots. Leading the way in the end, 14 points each. Scratch that for the Patriots. It's going to be 19 points leading the way is Lauren Taylor. How about 16 from Gilmore? 12 from Anaya Oliver. 11 from Kiana Lee. So four players in double digits for the Patriots. For Newberry, it was Peyton Cronin, and then with 14, Wisely with 14, including a couple late to try to keep things close in the fourth quarter. But key to this game was the shooting for the Patriots in the third and fourth quarter. Patriots in the third up to 50%, in the fourth up to 50%. Up until then, they had not hit at any better than a 38% clip on the day. So shooting absolutely improved on the Patriots side, and for Newberry, their shooting got ice cold. Shooting at a 25% clip in the third, 46% in the fourth. So the Patriots, congrats to them on their first victory of the season. FMU moves to 1-2. They'll head to Fayetteville State for a 2 o'clock matchup on November 19th. And then they'll return home Tuesday, November 22nd, just before Thanksgiving break. They'll match up against Conference Carolina's foe, Shawan University, in their first Conference Carolina's match of the season. Thanks again for joining us on the FM Patriot Network, where Patriots emerge victorious 73-64. We hope you have a wonderful Wednesday evening.
Year after year, with unwavering dedication, McLeod Health has stood shoulder to shoulder with families, friends, and neighbors, bringing healthcare expertise and compassion to all the communities we serve. As the region's most trusted healthcare resource, our physicians are here for you. Our nurses are here for you. The entire McLeod family is here for you. McLeod Health, here for life.
If you had to pause your favorite show because your spouse fell asleep, you've compromised enough. Pepsi Zero Sugar.